States wrestle with trans rights and reality in climate of factional fear. This is a topic report in which we're looking at how things are unfolding with trans rights versus how your rights match with other rights and the friction that is there. But we live in a world, well, we'll see. I'll let you see for yourself. So we have here the first headline here. State lawmakers aim to block doctors from giving treatment surgery to transgender people under 21. From MyFoxNews.com, Senate lawmakers introduced a bill this week that seeks to block doctors from giving treatment and gender-confirming surgery to those under 21 years old. So I think that's a little, that's probably 18, not 21. That's a, you know, if you're bondable, you should be able to make that decision, at least. Senate Bill 514, also known as the Youth Health Protection Act, would prohibit doctors from performing procedures like mastectomies, removing healthy body parts, or giving certain hormone treatments. 15 states consider bills on gender confirmation treatment, USA Today. Arkansas became on Tuesday the first state in the country to ban medical treatments for transgendered minors. The state's mostly Republican legislature voted to override Governor Asa Hutchinson's veto of House Bill 1570. So now it's law. So they overrode the GOP guy, alleged GOP guy. I'm not a GOP person myself, but you GOPers, well, I think you've already been saying, like, okay, well, we're done with Asa. Kansas lawmakers likely to pass bill on transgender athletes. LGBTQ rights advocates in Kansas are relying on the state Democratic governor or the courts or the corporate nationalists to hurt Kansas economically, which is, it's basically economic terrorism. I think we'll look back and kind of view these corporate nationalists as economic terrorists, which they absolutely are, right? At least by my standards. I'm not sure of the details of this bill, but I would imagine that this bill probably isn't well thought out, probably knee-jerk, black and white, doesn't really look at the nuance and complexity of the issues involved. South Carolina bill to ban transgender women from girls' high school sports resurface in State House. And this is from postandcourier.com. I guess the corporate nationalists are going to have to go after South Carolina now. Man, there's a growing list of states the corporate nationalists are going to have to try to economically murder. I don't know, man. I don't know. They went down this road. You claim power that you don't have, and you put yourself in a position where you have to try to exercise the power that you don't have. You're going to lose your effectiveness. Reproductive Health Care Center offers support for transgender youth. You're a reproductive health care center. That's an abortion clinic. You murder unborn children. Don't even pretend that you care about young people, because you don't. You only care about young people that society approves of. They have to earn. They don't even get to earn their right. They have to be lucky enough to be born to a human being that will bring them to term. And you're okay with those standards. You're okay with that type of ball worship. And that's exactly what it is. It's sacrificing your children so that you can go on and lead the life that you want, which is an unaccountable life. The history of trans children in medicine. Now, this was an interesting article, and I can't go into much more detail about it, but the article is making a case that there have always been transgender people and kids, and they've had these struggles, and they've had various transgender treatments, and they're saying that we shouldn't question, you know, medically treating transgender children. But what they cite is people that are basically, they can dress like girls if they're, you know, genetically, biologically boys. But it really doesn't there's nothing that I can see so far that shows long-term studies about the effects of hacking off body parts when children are children and filling them with chemicals. Highly powerful, highly mind-altering chemicals as a treatment for this. That maybe possibly you should have some long-term studies before you dive into these things. But none of, again, within this climate of factionalism where one side is basically screw transgender people, this is real simple, we're just going to shut it all down, to the other side saying transgender people, if you're transgendered, you could do nothing wrong. That Family Guy little clip where somebody's transgendered somebody's transgendered and, like, I don't know, the guy questions, like, how old they are, like, should you be drinking or something, like, I'm transgender, like, oh, well, you can do what you want. Those are the two extremes, and in a factional world, Well, we're not really going to get to the nuances that could really help us figure out exactly how to match the rights of humans with the reality of power. And we have it.